Up top.
Oh yeah, a bit of a tiff breaking out. Well, this time Skywrath Mage gets in on the action and they get Arcane Bolt. That's your first blood on the back of that one, as it is going to be Suniku who grabs it up.
Yeah, we get to about the 8 or 9 minute mark.
They're going right towards him when he's trying to get the stack. He's like, oh boy, they're going to make it as hard as possible. This is going to be so frustrating for Funic to get his blood, but look who comes on in. Havos is here to save the day, though. Sweeps on through, takes out that easy Skywrath Mage.
Na'Vi can take a fight and turn that into a stack steal. That's immense, but for now the smoke comes through.
They want to use this Ravage. They get on in there, they get a nice stun. The call down's going to be there from Havos. Can he burst him down? The follow-up Ravage is more than enough to take a bar Wisp, but with the rotation in from Dendi, he cleans out the sand.
Bottom line, Funic will be able to get out of a tough little spot there unless Cheshire Cat commits the Dream Coil. He will, and now Funic is actually in a bad spot.
Yeah, he gets put now, and he's going to have a hard time getting away. A few more right clicks could do it. Yep, they get it. Wisp is just a little too late to aid him. And now J4 under pressure. Havos moves on through, pulls out the cannons, and which does set him back a little bit from getting a hold of the initiating Blink Dagger, rather. Now they scout out FNG. Just going to try to walk away here. Get silenced up briefly, but he does not have Nature's Guise, so he's going to be walking his way, hopefully, on out. Pulls out a root, but it's not going to catch everyone, as Ditya. Right there behind, looking to chop him down in those back legs.
He's got a drum recipe out, so I guess this is going to be transitional item.
They want some nice stats. Nice Pearl Strike catches, epicenter follow-up, and he ends up going down. Unfortunately, this Wisp can't even get a quick enough relocate off to try to save his core friend. This is a bit awkward for now. Maybe they see FNG, they do. And he quickly steps back because they have their own vision on that high ground. Funic there on the top cliff. He's thinking about making a jump in. Can he kidnap someone in time?
Oh, no,
the
you
quick
can't.
Quick reaction coming out from PR. They're going to take Funic and also get a nice Ravage that catches two on the way in. And look who sneaks in from behind. Ditya going right for the prize position. The Wisp will be able to take him down solo. But look, Havos clean on through. Epicenter also coming in. Not going to catch a whole lot. But Dendi's looking to go in there. Dragon Tail catches. Fire Breath follow up takes down Sand King. A 3-for-2. Still advantage for PR. Mind you, but and this is just one of the things where, I mean, even with Roche's new location, linking on AJ4 to get a hold of Havos, just lingering in the front. He gets quickly bursted down. The follow of Ravage will make sure no one's going to be able to come in and aid him. And they do catch Funic on the high cliff right there.
They have been building up one big thing, and that's the Scotty on Slark right now.
Yep, he tries to put a little bit to use right there in the mid lane. And it's actually more than enough to get Havos pulled the hell out. Now, whether or not he comes back with a Havos, that's a different question. I don't think he is. Havos is already heading towards the top lane, so he's going to be there. But look who's lingering nearby. FNG, he just says, see ya. He just wisps himself right over
Dendi
to
bottom.
A nearby tree. Goes for the TP. Can he get it off? He will. Unfortunately, Ditya not going to be able to latch him in place, but runs right into Funic instead. Pounces on him. Trying to right-click it home. Can he burst him down in time? He can. Nice little solo pickoff right there, though. Needed. Ditya lingering around through the front while the rest of his team is smoked. Trying to do a play here. They're moving up actually to the north. They're going to try to jump in. Ravage catches everyone. Follow a Mystic Flare. Dendi is already BKB, but they quickly burst down the Wisp and first life of Havos. Havos comes back.
Wow.
And quickly, they return a nice root. He's going to start clearing house with fantastic damage spread amongst all the others. Meanwhile, going in from behind Ditya, trying to focus down Dendi if possible. Pull back from Funic, finishes off pesky little puck, and now Ditya, the focus fire point, going to try to leap himself away from this. Can he get away? One more right click could do it, and he gets it. Na'Vi, big fight for them after a strong initiation coming out from that Ravage. They're looking for a
dive.
Oh man, they're diving so hard to try to get a hold of this Skywrath. There's the buyback going to be coming out from Slark. They see it, they pull back. They haven't gotten anything, though, as far as objectives or tower structures, as this fight has happened outside the base, and it continues. Jump on through. Dendi now under pressure. Ditya might die back here if he gets too aggressive, and it's going to be forcing back the Tidehunter. Almost going to foyer. Skywrath ends up going down. They take down the Tidehunter. Slark able to slip away. J4 now back. It's all Na'Vi all day here inside the base, as they will be able to clean out the rest of this tier 3.
Because they really need some offensive from him, but oh, that lasso.
This is Funic, classic Funic, as he brings J4 out from the base and into their arms. They take him down quickly, and now Havos quickly uses the flat cannon to clean up the rest of the creeps. It's on PR now to try to pull out a big defense here. Tier 3 crumbles, Coil does land, it catches on Funic, but Dendi pulls on through and quickly bursts down with the aid of Havos, that puck. And now they turn their sights onto the racks, and this is going to be a first set of racks clean out. Havos going to pop out the BKB once more. They can't go for the secondary one as Slark has returned, and now he's looking for a bit of redemption. He blinks on through, gets a hold. Very nicely of Dendi. Root's going to be there. He locks them in place, but it's not going to be enough to prevent them from getting out. So Dendi's going to be one to fall here. In all or nothing at this point. If I get both my Ravages off in a fight, I've done my work. But, ooh, almost getting caught out. Funic not done yet. Forced F4, but they're very elusive at this point. Puck's going to be forced to sell fuels. Orb, can they prevent her from getting away? There's one Ravage that's going to be used on no one as the BKBs were popped. He might not even get that second Ravage off. Didya's trying desperately to kind of create space for him, and they will be able to catch a nice coil. There's the second Ravage, and it catches a lot more. Burrow strike follow-up, Epicenter, and it's PR pulling out a big fight. They take down Havost and FNG, and it's going to be Dendi and Wisp side-by-side trying to get a bit of defense themselves. They get out a nice kill there on Puck. Skywrath very low, not quite to fall there, and now they focus down. Dendi, Burrow, going to catch him in the midpoint, but it's going to be Funic who lasses up. Didya very low. Didya lives for now. He goes down. Nice grab there, but Funic now should fall. I think it's going to be a five-man takedown. Na'Vi all go down for PR's huge defense.
Just to make sure this doesn't happen, actually looking for a pickoff on Havos, but that's not going to happen. Oh, is it? The Puck coming in? We'll get the Dream Coil.
Oh, the Hex. My goodness. Gets a nice coil on two with the Yules on Wisp, and now Havos is forced to fight. Wisp goes down. Pops his BKB and just prays to God he can burst someone, but he can't even get the Skywrath Mage. He goes down.
Just like building up that lifesteal in the Aura Sense. Oh, Funic finding a nice opening. Is it enough, though, the Kraken show?
He has that Aegis, mind you, so if he gets in the heat of the storm, he still has a Ravage to fall back on in a secondary life. Now they use him again. Ditya is already well into the base, trying to help his friend. They're faking once, they're faking twice. Can he get a BKB to pop? No, he can't. Dendi not going to be having his BKB regardless. Now they just turn towards this tier 3 and begin to bring out right clicks. Blinking on through though, nice setup. Cheshire Cat gets Dendi. Coil there, one Ravage. And then he refreshes, gets a second Ravage on 3. And they're able to quickly take down Dendi. Havos still not buying back, has 10 more seconds. They turn their sights towards Funic, but he's about to not have a team to fall back on. Funic now forced to pull out his buyback. Dendi also his, as PR now on the offensive, managed to clear out a tier 3. Ditya is not done yet. He wants a Rex. He's going to go for it and get it. One more right click takes down the Rex, and now he's under pressure. But he goes right for Dendi. He has no buyback if he falls. But he's taking so much damage to the Epicenter. You got to be kidding me right now. PR bringing it back, but Havos dishing up the right clicks. They take down Havos. He now has to use that buyback. But Dendi's still out. Puck, Cheshire Cat.
Yeah, it's pretty insane that they're just upping the tempo for the full mid lane of Rex here. They know the buybacks are on cooldown. Or any buyback that was available could have been used. And oh my
Havos
god,
he's going to die. You jump in, they abyssal him down and just take apart Havos. Dendi and Havos are out of this game for well over a minute, at least for just Dendi. They turn back, they clean out FNG. Funic's very low, and PR might have just done their classic PR.
Jeez. I mean, look at this Lark. He's just huge. He's doing like 500 damage.
Again, takes the game back on the back of his Slark, but of course, more credit to also the rest of his team with a huge AoE spread and just beautiful execution in those previous fights with the fantastic Epicenter follow-up. Those Ravages went to prime use. It was just beautiful performance from Power Rangers.
Yeah, the power shift really came out with that Tidehunter Refresher Orb. Getting that second Ravage, that second